As you may know, I shoot Fujifilm, but recently I sold a Fujifilm camera and I bought a Canon camera. So what's happening? Let me explain. A couple months ago, I think it was in June, I bought Fuji X-T100 and I bought the camera because I wanted to upgrade my vlogging camera. Prior to X-T100, I had a Canon G9X, which is a point-and-shoot camera. And I want to upgrade my vlogging camera. And at that point, I did consider two options. The first option is Fuji X-T100, and the second option is Canon EOS M50. And at the end, I bought Fuji X-T100, mostly because of the X mount. Because I can use all my Fuji glasses on X-T100, thinking I can use X-T100 as a backup camera if needed. But after using it for a couple times, I just want to be honest with you that I'm actually disappointed with Fuji X-T100 as a vlogging camera. Some of you asked me about my experience with Fuji X-T100, so today let's talk about it. There are a couple reasons I don't like Fuji X-T100, and the first reason is autofocus. The continuous autofocus is relatively slow on Fuji X-T100, and the face detection works probably around 50% of the time, and sometimes it really takes a while for the camera to detect my face and focus on my face, and that is frustrating. It is so frustrating that I eventually decided not to rely on autofocus at all, and in the end, I just used manual focus. The second reason I don't like Fuji X-T100 is the video footage. I don't like the footage at all. I don't like the footage coming out of Fuji X-T100 because it is way over sharpened. It doesn't look natural at all. I don't know why Fuji does this. When you are shooting still photos with Fuji X-T100, I think there is a menu, sharpness, you can adjust the amount of sharpness. But when shooting video, no matter what you change, the footage coming out of the camera is way over sharpened. You probably didn't notice that much from my previous vlogs on YouTube because YouTube compressed the video. But when I look at the footage on my monitor, it's like, oh my God, what's happening? What's going on? I have to say this problem is worse than the wormy artifact problem with Lightroom. The third reason I don't like Fuji X-T100 is the audio quality. Fuji X-T100 doesn't come with a standard 3.5mm audio jack. Instead, it comes with a 2.5mm. But I have microphones like Rode Video Micro, which has 3.5mm, and I have to get an adapter to make the microphone work with Fuji X-T100. I'm not sure if it is the adapter or if it is the camera, but I didn't notice there is some background noise. There is some humming noise in the video, especially when you are not talking. So after 5 months of using the Fuji X-T100, I decided to trade it in, and I bought this Canon EOS M50. The dual pixel autofocusing works very well on this Canon EOS M50, although it doesn't work when you are shooting in 4K, but I don't shoot that much 4K anyway. Most of my vlogs are in 1080p. So yeah, in 1080p, the autofocusing just works. It locks on your face, and I like using it so far. The camera does come with a standard 3.5mm audio jack, and the footage coming out of this camera is sharp and natural. I tried a couple of shots here. I have some trees down there as my foreground, and I have the mountains in distance, and the mountains, you can probably only see half of the mountain because the other half is currently covered by a mist, and the sun is coming out of the mist, and I tried a couple of shots here. So from now on, I'm going to use this Canon EOS M50 to shoot my on-location vlogs, and hopefully you will see more vlogs coming out of this month or next month. Alright guys, that's it from me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you like it, please click on the thumbs up button below. And if you are the first time on my YouTube channel, please consider subscribing. Also, if you are interested in Capture One Luminar Aurora HDR 2019, check out the description below for coupon codes. You can save some money when you purchase the software license. Alright guys, until next time, bye for now.